Hi again, my dear students, IGCS students everywhere. Our lesson for now, for today, is bearings after trigonometry. So today we are in bearings. It's one of the most important topics. And it's related, the questions come on bearings related, and they come combined with the problems or the questions in the IGCSE exams with the trigonometry problems. So you have to know what are the bearings, how the questions come. It's short and simple and interesting lesson. You will be understanding fast. Okay, first we'll start with defining what does bearing mean. A bearing, what do you mean by bearings? A bearing is an angle, my dear students, an angle drawn. An angle drawn from north clockwise. Simple like this. This is the bearing. How can we ask questions and how can we sketch bearings? How can you understand and display them? For example, let's start with the first example. For example, B is to show the bearing now on A. Bearing of 56 degrees from A. Let's sketch this, sketch it, show it. Most of times the problems on bearings, they come drawn in the exams. They draw to you the diagram as students. But if they don't, look what we have to do. The main idea in this example and the next example, and when you do, because soon we'll be doing solving past paper problems, full past papers and selected ones. So in this example or others in bearings, only that we do. We look the position or the location after the word from, after the word from, which is A in this example. So A is the original position, original location, original point. We put it here, reference one. Then we do label it with A. Since the definition says north, my dear students, so we show the north line like this. This is the north line. Then we look at the other one. What did he say? B is on a bearing of 56 degrees. What does bearing mean, we said? It's an angle drawn from north. Look how to do. From north clockwise. You go from north clockwise. And we stop. It's better to show the arrow like this, that you are moving clockwise. Then you do this. So B is here. Finished. This is, and why we write this for three significant figures? It's a notation. This is the way that we display bearings with. But if you write in the exam 56 here is okay. But you have to be accurate when you define as mathematicians. This is the way that we display and show bearings with. Fine. So if we'll be drawing now, focus well, if we'll be drawing the bearing of A from B, look at the difference. The bearing of A from B. Of A from B. To do this, we draw north line at B, like this, bearing of A from B. What's after from now? B. What do you have to do? We draw a line. Now we draw an angle. So this is the bearing here. What is it? It's an angle from north at B. This is the mean by or of bearing of A from B. We draw an angle clockwise. Look, clockwise from B. From B until you reach A. This is the bearing of A from B. We draw the angle at the position after the word from. Which is what in this, if you said calculate, find the bearing. What is the bearing? What's the value? What's the angle? What is the measure? What's the size? We use geometric rules now. You must remember angles rules. Angles rules. So this one is 180 minus 56. Remember here, when we have two north lines, focus with this fact. Two north lines are always parallel. So this angle and this angle, they are called allied angles. For example, this is X, this is Y. X and Y, they add up to 180 degrees. They are allied. Remember this from basic geometry? Supplementary angles. Allied angles. Allied. They add up to 180 degrees. So in our example, this is 56, so this is 180 minus 56, which is 124 degrees. So what's the bearing? This is the step one. So what's the bearing? This angle. Now this angle, we are angles at a point, circle angles. So the bearing of A from B is 360 minus 124, which is 236 degrees. Easy? Let's show now how the examples may come on bearings. Example 2. Example 2. I will write example like general to any school student. So this is the question. If the bearing of my school, let's call it S to not write it every time. If the bearing of my school from my house, let's call it H, a little like this, is 72 degrees. Part A, find the bearing, the bearing of my house from my school. So my school is S, my house. B is H. B, if the distance, between my school and my house is 5 kilometers. The question is, how far south is, my house from my school? These questions look like challenging or no, but look now how this, to answer this quick and fast in a couple of minutes even, we have to draw the question well. So as we said, the key word in this lesson is the from. The position or the location here, which is the house or my house, is after the word from. Then you come here, simple like this, you label it like this with H. then you do north line. Then he said, his school is where now? Here, we don't know where. This is the way that we think in bearings. So what do you do in this case? You look at the angle, 72, then you go, look, move. Clockwise, my dear, clockwise, 72 like this. Then we stop. So this is 72 degrees. So here is my school. Not here. Look how the bearings help us to show the direction. Where is it? Where is position from another one? Fine. Let me just remove this to be more clear. Easy? This is. Part A, what does he want? He wants to look, he asked me the opposite now. What's the bearing of that from us? From us. Now I draw the angle from us. So I must show the north line. North line, every time. Any position, I must show the north line. So what's the angle that we want? As we explained in the first, this angle. Show the arrow, show that you are moving accurately and correctly. So to find this angle, this is the bearing. We have two steps for part A. Two step number one, 180 minus 72 is 108, because this angle and this angle, this angle and this angle are allied angles or supplementary angles. They add up to 180. So this angle is 180 minus 72, which is 108 degrees. Step two, what's the bearing? Finished. So the bearing is 360 minus 108, which is 252 degrees. Easy. If you are like to be more accurate, just try the bearing. So the bearing of H from school is 252 degrees, which is this angle. Part B, my dear students, how far south, if they are school, I'll draw it again here, school and the house, it's 5 kilometers apart, or the distance between them is 5 kilometers. How far south is the house from the school? It's true, look, it's south. House is here, look, this is the east and west line. So this is the north. So look, school is north or on north of house, and the house is on south. How far south is the school from the school? So you want this one. This is the distance that we are finding. Because of this, now we'll be forming right angle triangle. So this is that we are finding. In part B, what is the value of H? How far is H? How many kilometers is H? What's the distance at? This that he wants. South. Not this one, not this one. This is the south. Good. This here we have until now insufficient information on this. But this shape came. Why we are saying insufficient information, my dear students? Because we got this shape, we draw it here from this shape. So remember, this angle was 72 degrees. This is 90 degrees. So this is 18 degrees. Now, because before, if we don't have the angle now like this, there is no angle. I will delete it. How can you solve this triangle? No one can, because only the right angle triangle, this one, yeah, this that we are solving now. H is a side in this triangle. Only we are given, or we know one side. How can you solve it? Remember, cases in trigonometry and right angle triangle. We don't, so we have another side. We must be given another side or another angle. Another side we are not given, but we are given this angle or this one, as you wish. If this 72, so this is 18, because this is 90 minus 72. Or this by alternate is 72. And this is right, as we wish. So two cases we can solve here. We can start with using the 18 degrees, my dear students. So H is the opposite for 18. Yes? Sine 18 is equal to H over 5. Or cosine 72 is equal to H over 5. Both are right. Both are right. Both are right. By calculator, by cross multiply, H is equal to, look, you have the same answer now. 5 sine 18, which is, or H equals to 5 cosine 72. Try both. H is equal to 1.55 kilometers for three significant figures. All you do here is the same answer. You can check. Why? Because the opposite of this angle is the adjacent to this. So we are free. We do 90 minus 72 is 18, or by alternate. If a student does this, it's right. If a student does the alternate case, because there are north lines, so this is Z, alternate case by basic trigonometric rules and geometric rules. So the bearing is easy. This is the main questions and main ideas like in the IGCSE exams, comes like this. True, we have harder problems, but we'll do them by the past paper problems with combined with the sine and cosine rule and triangle problems and so on. Hear from me soon, inshallah. Thank you so much.